another gem from the vault that is Spiegel's mind and history. Your father, very particular eating habits. He likes his pizza crispy.
Yes.
Almost to the point where it's burnt, covered in all sorts of weirdness. He couldn't have a piece of fish unless the damn thing was slathered in all sorts of strange onions and vegetables. And you said that it... Meal times were not joyous times for you around the house because of the way your dad ate.
No, and you know, I would want a slice of pizza that wasn't crisp and that wasn't covered in vegetables completely, to the point where you couldn't even see the cheese.
It's almost like a salad
or the crust, for that matter.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but when you order a pizza like that, they charge extra. People want that.
Well. The pizza that he baked would be in the house, and I just wanted one or two slices for myself.
Straight cheese. Mm-hmm.
And he wanted his tea extra hot. Hot, hot, extra hot, steaming hot.
Scald me and sue McDonald's hot.
Every night, I think I told you... We had a full course meal. We had a grapefruit salad, soup.
You said grapefruit?
Yeah, grapefruit.
You're starting dinner off with a grapefruit?
Yeah, that's right.
Whoa. I don't know that.
Salad, soup, in this order.
Okay.
And then the main meal.
Where would the soup come from? Is it like in a can, or do they make soup?
Why the f*** are they having grapefruit?
I don't know,
soup
actually.
And salad and grapefruit?
And grapefruit?
Yes. We haven't even had the entree yet.
My father was a hungry man.
Look, that's good eating, man. Trust me. It's a lot of work, though.
And he liked radishes in his salad.
Yeah, so did my dad. My dad loved radishes.
Jicama.
What is it with you old guys and your radishes? Get them out of here.
Radishes are terrible.
They suck.
They're sour styrofoam. No one likes radishes. No one gets drunk and craves a radish. Is that why you eat the way that you do these days, which you eat very simply? You're a simple man with simple tastes. You like butter in your mouth and lollipops in your... And you don't eat very flamboyantly.
And I forgot to mention, under all the vegetables that completely covered the slice of pizza, he would usually squeeze some ketchup on top of the cheese.
Monster! Monster! Josh, I will never speak ill of your two beautiful parents, but no one's perfect, okay? I think we all know that I almost drowned in a pool during a Coke orgy when I was 7, and your dad put ketchup on pizza. Lord knows what skeletons are in Ron and Rita's closet.
I don't know, man.
Horrifying people.
You seem pretty boring.
Black tar
heroin. Boring ones are the ones you gotta worry about.
Uh-huh, yeah. Looking at you, Cosby. So, we ask you, 410-338-1098, what sort of weird... eating habits did your families have or put you through? Christina checks in and says, my mom hated tacos, never ate Mexican food unless you counted her bland AF chicken fajitas only seasoned with pepper. She would only season things with pepper. No salt, just pepper. Siobhan says, my dad would make a tomato-based gutter fish stew.
That sounds delicious.
I'd have to trust Siobhan here. And then Russell Holly says the food was normal, but the dinner time itself was early because Dad would get home at 3 and dinner would be at 4.
Oh, yeah, we had to wait for my father to get home for dinner. I'd be starving. Starving. Sometimes he wouldn't get home till 7:30.
Dude, this f***ed him up.
This is a weird one. My father insists that every meal be served on a hot plate. My mom would heat the plates in the oven to serve on. I do it too, and my kids and boyfriend hate it. Well, stop doing it. Why is this? That's ridiculous.
Break your programming. Oh, that's so, so strange. I remember my father, he would have the bean soup. One day we'll talk to my brother or father about the bean soup, that it was just this his own homemade recipe, and he'd put like a big pork knuckle in there, and it would stink. Oh, it'd stink. It would smell like you fricasseed a fart. And he'd make enough of it that my brother and I would genuinely get emotional on a Sunday because we knew we'd be eating this for 5 days. And it did not get better like lasagna. Every day it stunk more and began to gelatinate.
Sick.
It's an awful, awful thing to do to a young child. All I want is an Uncrustable. Let's go to the phones, 410-338-1098, to find out what you went through. Let's start with Nathan, Westminster. Good morning.
Morning.
I've never even heard of this that's written on the screen. What would your mom drink?
So it wasn't my mom. It was my friend's mom.
Okay.
And she would drink this mushroom that was sitting in, like, she would get like a mushroom or some kind of fungus, put it in the vat of jar water, let sit for like 2 months, and then just slowly sip it every day.
She'd
until the whole thing was empty.
Drink fermented mushroom juice.
Yes.
Oh,
I've never heard of that either.
Your friend's mom
was
Marjorie Deal.
Supposed to do?
Did she say there's a reason?
Healthy. It was healthy. It cleansed. It brought things that you can't get from normal food.
No.
Et cetera, et cetera.
No.
I mean, it looked like I don't know what the thing is, but the Metroid, like, jellyfish thing in a jar from the Samus games. Like,
oh,
that's what
shout out
like.
Metroid. Shout out Mother Brain, Kraid, and Ridley. Ugh, yuck. No, I don't want anything that's described as something I'd see in Metroid. Oh, it's so foul. Let's talk to... this is weird. Let's talk to Dan in Frederick. Dan, good morning.
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 What's up, Dan?
Well, not a whole lot. How's it going for you all?
Oh, it's sweet. I'm looking forward to today. I think it's going to be nice and sunny out.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So anyway, my dad, growing up, he would go to the store and get the gallon bucket of ice cream that you get, and just vanilla ice cream. Mm-hmm. He'd bring it home, mm-hmm. and every night he would scoop himself a bowl of ice cream, mm-hmm. put chocolate syrup on, not normal there,
okay.
and then he would follow up with Parmesan cheese and crunched up potato chips.
Oh.
In the ice cream?
In the ice cream.
I may try that.
I'd try the chips. The cheese I'm having trouble getting my head around, especially Parmesan.
I think it's just the salty and the sweet, right?
Yes, that's absolutely it.
That's obviously what it is.
Plus, you've got the creaminess versus the crunch, the salt versus the sweet. You lost me at Parmesan cheese.
My father also would freeze nuts. And at the end of his 7-course dinner, he would buy so many nuts, like bags and bags, all different kinds of nuts, cashews.
Love cashews.
Pistachios.
Love pistachios.
Almonds.
I mean, me and your father would have got along great.
And he would freeze them he would eat them frozen with steaming hot scalding tea. Okay? And sometimes, he wouldn't have cake for dessert. He'd take the frozen slice of bread out and put jam on the frozen slice of bread. And I think he put that in his mouth and he'd let the tea melt it in his mouth.
None of these sound that weird to me.
I don't want to tell
tea
you
and
this,
nuts.
Man. Your dad was the Zodiac killer. Okay. Your dad was the Zodiac.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, only a person that eats frozen bread with jam, ice cold pistachios, peanuts, cashews, walnuts, and macadamia nuts with tea so hot you could scald meat off bone. That man was writing long letters to the newspaper about what he's done and what he will do again. Man, the pieces are falling in place right now. Oh, man, Spiegel. Let's talk cheer. Oh, yuck. Beth in Falston. Good morning.
Good morning.
Ugh.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you just fine.
Okay, great. So my grandfather did the most nasty thing. He would take, like, the most grit white bread, and then he would take a can of that nasty meat, you know, like spam or corned beef, whatever it is, that came in the can, had like the little key that you had to unravel.
Yeah.
Shake that log meat out of there.
Oh,
and then it had,
yeah.
And then it had this like gelatinous glaze all over it.
Yeah.
And he would scrape it off and wipe it on his bread like a condiment.
Like the gelatin?
The gelatin.
Oh my God, I'm not kidding. My mouth started to water. My fingertips are getting the tingles. Oh, God.
Yeah.
That's
on his, like, grit white bread, and then he would just slather that stuff on there, and then his log meat.
Oh, ew. Stop saying log meat.
Oh, stop saying log meat.